Alright, what's up people? This is Sif Urien, and right now we're going to be jumping into Chapter 3, The Case of the Missing Lifeguard, Stranger Things 3. Man, things are really picking up. So last episode, Billy basically kidnapped the other lifeguard, the girl, and took her to... I can't think of like a name that we could actually give it right now, but it's basically the Mind Flayer, but in physical form. I think what's happened is it took all the rats that exploded and took all the mush, the tissue and everything, and just combined it into one massive physical form. As far as Billy, I think Billy's something different. I think he might be, I don't know, like I think he might be a little bit like Will from last season, but I think he still has kind of like his own conscience in there, but he's just kind of like trapped. I don't know, it's way too early to really tell what's happening with Billy, but I think we're definitely going to be having kind of a body snatchers type of shit going on. I think this lifeguard girl is just going to end up getting, I guess you could use the term, possessed, the same as Billy. Because when Billy was standing on the street shouting to him like, what do you want? I don't understand. There was quite a few people standing on the street. So if we do go down the road of like body snatcher type of shit, I think the fear factor, the scare factor for our characters isn't necessarily going to be some creature that's going to come through the wall or come crashing through the window. It could be the person standing next to him. It could be their mum, their dad, you know. So we've got that kind of going on. Plus, there's Jonathan and Nancy there on the storyline of the rats. They're doing their own like little investigation. Even though Nancy's boss and everything has told her to kind of leave it and go get a coffee. it's so fucked, really. But of course, that's going to have a payoff later on or whatever when she breaks the story and stuff. Puts everyone in their place type of shit. Plus, you've also got Will's mum, Joyce. She's doing her own little investigation, trying to find out what's going on with the magnets. What led to her going to the science teacher, trying to get some help. And Hopper ended up sadly getting stood up at the restaurant. It sucks. I've been there. I know what it's like to get stood up on dates. It sucks. You just carry on getting drunk, man. that's my solution. So with all of that kind of going on, in the midst of it all, we have Eleven and Mike. Like, Eleven has now dumped Mike. She dumped his ass. Mike could have handled that so much better, just so much easier, you know. But it is what it is, you know. Things were going too good. Like, when things go really good in a TV show, expect some drama. Expect some shit. Because you can't just keep things just nice and happy. There has to be some drama, what kind of brings them back together later on. but yeah, we're going to get into this. Episode 3, well, Chapter 3, The Case of the Missing Lifeguard. Let's do this, man.
Hey, don't worry about it, okay? He'll come crawling back to you in no time, begging for forgiveness. I guarantee you, him and Lucas are like totally wallowing in self-pity and misery. We're going, oh, I hope they take us back. God, what I wouldn't give to see their stupid faces. What is it?
No. No way. that's kind of wrong, man.
I see them. What are they doing? Eating.
What did I do wrong?
Stop. Relax. Just relax. Stop asking.
Because women act on emotion and not logic.
Precisely. It's a totally different species.
They say we are species. Emotion, not logic. What?
They broke up with you. What else is there to talk about?
Tons.
Yeah, we're trying to solve the great mystery of the female species.
Dude. You can smell the nacho cheese.
I got that beat.
What?
Oh, no.
No, Lucas, no.
No.
Oh, wow.
What happened?
Boys. That's what happened. My God.
Hey! When I say 3 inches... Three...
Do you knock? Jeez. Yeah. Jeez.
Oh. I'll leave. I'll leave.
Hey, silver lining on a shitty night out, man.
I Okay, look, I should just warn you, if he's with a girl or doing something gross, just get out of there right
away. What?
You're scarred for life.
Max? Just clocked onto what they were doing, okay. Oh shit, thinking about it, this is how, okay, okay. She's gonna see Billy do something now, isn't she?
Just stay with her, she's gonna.
Oh shit, he can actually like sense her and see her or some, oh my god.
What is it? What happened?
Oh fuck. Okay. See, like, I weren't too sure, like, right at the start when they were spinning the bottle, I thought, like, who would you kiss or whatever, but, like, spin the bottle type of shit, you know what I mean? But I really didn't think she would start spying on people. Like, what the hell? But it's a smart way to try and, like, bridge people's storylines, you know what I mean? See, now is Billy gonna, like, okay, does he know who that was? I don't think Billy in season two, I don't think he saw Eleven, did he? No, because they had already left when he went to Joyce's home and everything happened with Max and stuff, right? So.
Oh, God.
Yep. I've had my fair share of those mornings.
Oh, look who it is.
We need to talk.
Yeah, we do. Okay, you're freaking me out.
Yeah, it fell in the night. It lost its magnetism.
Oh, did it?
And the same exact thing happened at my house.
Wow.
And I thought, okay, that's weird, right? Why are all these magnets suddenly losing their magnetism? Uh-huh. So I went and saw Scott.
Scott? Who's Scott?
Scott Clark.
Your child science teacher?
He's pretty brilliant, actually. And I asked him how.
You stand me up, no phone call, no apology, because you had to go to Scott Clark's house.
Yeah. And he thinks...
I don't care what Scott thinks!
He thinks that a large-scale magnetic field could be built using some sort of machine or experimental technology.
He's brilliant. Really brilliant. Is he single, too?
Wow, Hop, come on.
What if it's them? To build a machine like this, you need resources. You need scientists, you need funding.
Yeah, I was wondering why she was like latching onto it so much.
Yeah, take me back there.
To the lab.
Yeah, I want to go back.
Because some magnets fell off your fridge.
Yes.
Okay, makes sense.
Thank you.
It makes sense. I'm sorry. I'm a little busy right now, but I'm thinking maybe wow. We can meet up there. Like
I get it, but at the same time, like, look at everything that's happened.
Joyce! What the hell are you doing?
I need to borrow these.
No, you're not going back there. Joyce, son of a bitch!
Wow. So that's him now on that storyline. Investigating the magnets. Well, investigating the cause of the magnets. Losing their magnetism.
Thing. When Billy is alone with a girl, they make, like, really crazy noises.
They scream?
Yeah, but, like, happy screams.
Oh. Oh.
Ice. It's just ice. It's probably for his muscles or something. He works out like a maniac.
It's not for his muscles.
Where's the sailor man?
Sorry, he can't help you. He's busy.
Busy with what?
Spycraft.
See anything? I guess I don't.
They're looking for Russians.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know what an evil Russian looks like. Seriously, if you say Robin again.
Robin, man,
she's not my type.
What's your type again? Not awesome?
Thank you. She did drama. That's a bad look, and she's in band? No.
Now that you're out of high school, which means you're technically an adult, Don't you think it's time you move on from primitive constructs such as popularity?
A primitive construct? Yeah. That's some stupid shit you learned at camp. And let's think about how exactly did you score that beautiful girlfriend? Oh yeah, with my advice. Because that's how this works, Henderson. I give you the advice, you follow through, not the other way around, all right, P-Brain?
Yeah. See, the first kind of setup there that Robin might be like a little bit of like a love interest. Did you guys hear that? Okay.
I'll use my torch to set fire to the chamber, sacrificing ourselves, killing the Jujus, and saving the Kuwazar. You guys win. Congratulations.
Will, I was just messing around.
Let's finish for real.
Yeah.
How much longer is the camp?
Just forget it, Mike. We'll just call the girls afterwards.
I said forget it, Mike, okay? I'm going home.
Oh, come on, man. Every fucking season, Will's got to go through some shit.
You're ruining our party.
That's not true. Really? Where's Dustin right now? See? You don't know and you don't even care. And obviously he doesn't either and I don't blame him. You're destroying everything. And for what? So you could swap spit with some stupid girl? Elle's not stupid. It's not my fault you don't like girls. I'm not trying to be a jerk. Okay?
Oh, shit.
I mean, what did you think, really? That we were never gonna get girlfriends? That we're just gonna sit in my basement all day and play games for the rest of our lives? Yeah. I guess I did. I really did. Will. Will!
Oh, man. Yeah, he wants to just... Okay, one, he wants it to go back to what it was like when they were kids before everything. And just them four was friends just hanging out. But now that, like, they're becoming teenagers, they're more interested in girls and everything, and could Will be gay?
We found this.
That's Heather's. I'll get it back to her.
We could give it back to her.
You could, except she's not here. Failed on me today.
Heather. Do you think you can find her?
Oh shit. Right, but to kind of quickly go back onto Will, like, oh man, I just want to give the kid a hug. I really do. You've been through, like, that kid has been through way too much, man. He's seriously going to need, like, counseling and shit when he's older, like. My God. Oh shit.
What happened? Elle!
Oh shit! See, because if they've took over the girl, like body snatch the type of shit, like they've done to Billy, then that girl is actually the girl's conscience, like sinking away, fading into the darkness. Oh, don't.
Joyce, you okay?
I'm fine.
Oh, there is someone home.
Target acquired.
Where?
10 o'clock, Sam Goody's.
Give me that. Shit.
Really?
Evil Russian.
Listen up! I just have one question for you. Who is ready to sweat?
He's a fucking instructor. What the fuck?
Yeah, ladies, let's warm it up. Breathe out of your hips. Start feeling that burn everywhere down the loins, right? Come on, ladies, show me what you got. Slow down. Just isolate. Wow, tip that up. That feels good.
Silver cat blue meets yellow in the west. A trip to China sounds nice if you tread lightly.
So she cracked it.
Tread lightly.
She's going to be the one to figure it out, isn't she? I can already tell.
Silver cat.
your cat.
Russia.
You did too.
No, I did
yes,
not.
Yes, you did.
No, I did none of that.
A trip to China sounds nice.
Chinatown, like a Chinese restaurant or something.
A trip to China sounds nice.
Yeah.
A trip to China sounds nice. If you tread lightly. If you tread lightly. When blue and yellow meet in the west, it's yellow in the west.
Oh, shit.
Robin.
I cracked it.
Cracked what?
I cracked the code.
Wow. Still don't get what the fuck it all means, though.
It is important to me that you feel safe. That you and your family feel safe. I want you to feel like this can still be your home. You didn't think I'd find out about that? Gary called me. He said he's fixing up your house to put it on the market.
Oh, wow.
You have people that know what you've been through. You have people that care about you. Right here.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, people like Scott Clark. That was a joke. What's that?
Oh, shit. Oh, nice shot, man. I like that shot.
Something is coming. Something hungry for blood.
What is it?
What if it's the Demogorgon? Oh, Jesus, we're so screwed if it's the Demogorgon.
It's not the Demogorgon.
Oh, they all look so small. Like I said, I just want to just give him a big hug, you know? Oh, poor Will, man. Yep. Get tooled up, you guys know the drill. Literally eating shit. What the fuck?
Hey, what's in there?
It's just more boxes.
Let me check it out.
No, I'm still looking.
Let me see it.
Hang on.
Yep. Steve's definitely got like a little love interest this season, I think. Shit, it's that fucking Russian dude. Oh shit. He just fucked Copper up. Oh no! Heather's dad is the fucking head of the newspaper.
I'm sorry. Where is who?
Well, they're a little burnt, I'm sorry.
Heather! This is my sister Maxine. And I'm sorry, I did not quite catch your name.
Al.
Al.
I saw your manager. At the pool, he said you guys didn't come into work today, so we got worried.
Heather wasn't feeling so hot today, so we thought we'd take the day off to nurse her back to health.
But you're feeling just fine right now, aren't you, Heather?
I'm feeling so much better.
Yeah, she's now with Billy. Oh, shit. If we are going to get like a body snatchers shit, they're going to take the parents, and it's smart because the father is the head of the newspaper, so it's like you can control the source of information. Yeah, he now knows it's her. Yep, come on. I am so fucking, oh my god, man, this is so good.
Stairs and lie down for a bit.
Janet?
Oh, wow.
Janet, call 911! Call 911!
I'm really sorry about this, Daddy.
Oh, fuck. Oh, man. It is going to end up being like a body snatcher type of shit, isn't it? It really is. Honestly, I don't even want to sit here and talk. I want to just watch the next one. Oh, man. Ah, okay, so now Billy or the Mind Flayer or whatever they really are, they know who was the person who closed the gate and everything. Her name's Eleven. She's friends with Max. Are they going to try and go after Max now and Eleven? But then saying that, the whole thing with Will, like, consents it. And he told Mike and Lucas that he's back. It's like, okay, shit's hit the fan again. We need to bring everybody in. Or are we going to stay in these small groups? Like every single season, everyone's in like their own little storyline until it's time for them all to come together. Like Hopper and Joyce, they're on their storyline. You got Nancy and Jonathan, they're on their own storyline. Eleven and Max, they're on their storyline. And I guess now with Will telling Mike and Lucas that he's back, they're starting on their separate storyline to do with the main thing. Oh man, hold up. Let me just double check. How many episodes? There's 8 episodes. So with the next one, it's going to be the halfway point. So maybe in the next episode or episode 6, that's when everyone will start coming together. I reckon it's getting so good, man. It's getting so, so good. Like, to kind of stay on topic of Will, I kind of get where like he's coming from about how like he just wants to play D&D. Like he just kind of he wants to stay a kid. You know, everyone else is growing up. I get it. And if his character is going to be gay, what first off, I think would be kind of cool, you know, to have one of the main group to be gay. You know, and if he really is gay, then that would kind of explain why he's kind of, in a way, the opposite to the like all the other boys in the group. You know what I mean? How they all want to go out with girls and everything. Like, this is back in the 80s. This was before, like, being gay was more of a common, more openly accepted type of thing. You know what I mean? So maybe he does feel like he's an outsider. He's not connected in the group like he used to be before. I mean, like, before becoming a teenager and like, before everything that happened in the show. But I feel for him, man. Like, this kid, like I said, like, this kid has been through so much shit. He's going to need counselling or shit when he's older, man. Seriously, like, this kid just can't get a break. I just want to just wrap my arm around him and just give him a cuddle and tell him it's going to be okay, you know? I just feel for Will. I really do. Like, poor kid. It actually breaks my heart. It actually breaks my heart to see this little kid fucking always suffering every fucking season. And if anything, it's even worse this season. You know, his pain and suffering is even worse this season because his pain and suffering is brought on by his friends. While, like, the last two seasons, his friends and family was the only thing that kind of kept him kind of going, you know what I mean? As far as Nancy and Jonathan, like, they've now come across the whole lady eating shit, literally eating shit. Like, she kind of took over now. Like, it's... We still don't know exactly what's going on and who's who. Like, is the mind flare inside the body of the rat monster thing at the basement of that factory steel place? And Billy and Heather, they are nothing more than just the soldiers, the troops. Or are they a part of the actual mind flare? Like, we still don't know it a lot at the minute. But very quick, right? Robin, Steve, and Dustin, I am loving them three together. I really am. Like, just the way that they're written and the way that they're bouncing off each other. Like I thought Steve and Dustin were so good before, but to add Robin into the group as well, like that little, like, threesome, that little kind of like triple threat, if you will, just works. They are so good together. And I do honestly think Robin might end up being like a love interest for Steve. Because I think like it's been twice now, right? Twice there's been like two potential kind of setups. The first half was a dialogue that Dustin and Steve had, where Dustin was saying to him like maybe you should be with somebody that you like and not just because they're popular and stuff. And then the other setup was a little bit of danger and like holding hands quick, you know. Like I said, like she looks at him as kind of like a doof, like he's a chump. But when shit hits the fan, like he has done before, he's gonna shine and step up and everything. And she might look at him in like a different light. Yeah, right now, like there's a very subtle, slow potential build up there. But right now, with the way like the pacing of the show, it seems to be kind of quick. So I don't know if we're gonna have enough time to like throw in a little love story. Like I don't know. But yeah, I'm gonna watch the next one. I'm gonna carry on binge watching. I am sweating like crazy. I already had like an hour break between episode 2 and this one, so I'm probably gonna need to have a bit more of a break. Anyway, I'm gonna jump into episode 4 next. Get cracking on with these. Get these up as soon as I possibly can. Well, just get them filmed as soon as I can. Because I give it about 48 hours before I'll start seeing thumbnails or spoilers and shit on other people's videos. And I don't want to get spoiled. So I want to just get as many done as I can today. And then probably start of next week, I will film the rest if I can. I've still got loads of other stuff to edit and... Man, give this video a thumb up if you like it. Comment down below, let me know what you think, and subscribe if you haven't already, man. All right, I've been Sifurian, and I'll catch you in the next one, man.